she died, I would lose my mind. Oh no! My bed, she died.
I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. Confidence is never a question when it comes to wide receivers, and these two are no different. It's Benjamin's Panthers going up against Evans's Buccaneers. So let's get you over to Tampa as we say hello to our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, we are at a site that's played host to two Super Bowls, and that's Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Carolina Panthers and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And we say hi again, everybody. Brandon Godden here as we count down to kickoff. I turn to my partner, that's Charles Davis. And Charles, Larry pointed out in the open, we've got a pretty good matchup of wide receivers here this afternoon, don't we?
And those guys have such a big impact on the game nowadays. We know it's a throwing game, but the guys who can go up and get it, the guys who can break tackles after the catch and make bigger plays, oh, yeah, they love spotlight as well. They want the football. They want the attention.
The children will groan. It's the final weekend of summer, but we've got the NFL, and we're underway on EA Sports. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. And Cam Newton brings out the 6-10 Carolina Panthers. And, boy, I know it's tough for the fans to hear that 6-10 record because they expected a lot more this year coming off the Super Bowl appearance. What questions need to be answered in the offseason?
Well, I think let's start on offense and keep it there because the offensive line, both tackles, I think more help at wide receiver, at running back. And Cam Newton, they've talked about the ability of him to evolve as a quarterback. They want to kind of use the Ben Roethlisberger model, where he doesn't run as much, the ball's out of his hands quicker in the pocket, and becomes better and more proficient, more accurate with his throws downfield. They want to take some of those hits off of him and extend his career.
And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was at the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly right. Can't wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Back to the air, Newton on second down. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. On the defensive side of the football for the Bucs, here's the lineup. You know, you look at last year, 2016, 23 points a game right in the middle of the league, but improved, I think. How do they look going forward?
Well, they did improve, and they improved throughout the second half of the year. They focused on communication. They cut down some of the stuff they were doing defensively, made it simpler, and they played a lot faster. And look, Gerald McCoy is a terrific player on the defensive line. You got linebackers that can run in Levante David and Quan Alexander. And I thought the Keith Tandy really emerged as a safety for them down the stretch and made some big-time plays. It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. They are going to go for it. It's Newton escaping the pressure right. And this is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. Well, that, my friend, I guess is the definition of a head-scratcher. Fourth and long, this stage of the game, what were they doing?
I just have to believe that he looked at the situation, still in the first half, decided there's a time to be aggressive. Now was it, because there's still time to make up for it if things don't go right. Of course, a lot of questions on this one. And look, I want to go for it as much as anyone.
But fourth and long?
Yeah, I don't think I would have there. that one seemed a little bit on the irrational side.
Fans might be a little angry at that one. Now a second down throw for Winston. Finding time. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's third down.
After watching him drop that slant, I can hear my old coach's voice ringing in my ears right now. You can't run with the ball until you catch it. Trying to get those rack yards before he secured it.
On third down, Winston. He's got Evans. 8 yards there on a first down. And that's the first connection, the number one overall pick at 2015, finding the number seven pick at 2014 in Evans.
And what a great target Mike Evans is for Jameis Winston. Winston's a pretty accurate thrower, but that catch radius that Evans provides, that makes him that much more dangerous.
Now Sims. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and nine.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1 yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional 1 yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
And they'll get him down right around the 16. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Winston from the gun on third down. Looking for someone to throw to. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Partner, how many times have you heard it? Pressure creates diamonds, right? But it also bursts pipes. And on that one, that's what they got. They got after him, and he was fortunate just to get rid of it.
Yeah, he just had to chuck it away. And Aguayo's kick is good. And the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. So the folks here in the stands this afternoon, they're happy about that one. Their guys get the early advantage after the opening drive field goal.
And they should be happy. Their guys look good getting down the field, and that's got to give them hope that good things are in store here today.
Roberto Aguayo following the made field goal, set now to kick this one away. Fozzie Whitaker now on the return. Ooh, with a juke. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to three, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than three. And that's exactly what happened.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They'll run. This is Jonathan Stewart. Second down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to third and three now. And the numbers down a bit from their Super Bowl year this season for Jonathan Stewart. Did have some injuries. He finished with 824 yards. 9 touchdowns, though. Good in that department.
When it's around the goal line, he's a terrific runner because he knows how to get there, and he can run through contact, run through trash, as we like to say. That's part of the reason he accumulates the injuries that he does, because he runs inside a lot and takes on those linebackers. But they're going to work on Jonathan Stewart in the offseason, get him healthy, and have him back ready to go for next season. On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
So the offense has it first and 10. On first down, Newton. This is caught. It's Greg Olsen. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
Okay, I have to take a second here and talk about Greg Olsen, the tight end for the Carolina Panthers. Third straight year over 1,000 yards in receptions. And guess what? That's the first time that's ever happened in NFL history. Three straight years by a tight end.
That's really something. Now 31 years of age. They're going to need him next year to turn it around because a very disappointing season.
Not the season anyone expected, least of all the Carolina Panthers, but he's a building block that they can go ahead and get back to form starting in 2017.
Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position.
I love the way that you described it, paved well. Oftentimes, the guy who gets home on the blitz, he's going to get all the credit, but his teammates did all the dirty work, right? They ran into people on purpose. They sometimes tugged on jerseys to hold linemen to create space and gaps. And that play finished off really, really well. Well-conceived, well-designed, and even better executed.
Throwing is Newton, and he finds a man. It's Olsen. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Stewart is the lone setback. Now Newton and the tight end Dixon left side. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. And it'll result in a fresh set of downs.
The coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Now Stewart on first down. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. And now Stewart still down after the play. And you hope it's not a re-aggravation of that foot injury. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. And the inaugural carry here for Fonzie Whitaker. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. 8 yards on the run, and that cuts us down to a third and about five. So just a lone field goal in this first quarter of play. 3-0 is our score. We'll return to Tampa after this message. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
With my good friend Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin with you. It's the Panthers in possession of the football as we begin quarter number two. They're on the march, but facing a third down here. Newton now to throw. And Dixon over the middle. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the six. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Play clock winding down. Back to throw, Newton. That's caught at the one. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top.
And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Jonathan Stewart taking it in. And the Panthers have taken the lead.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that drive, 12 plays in length, and it's capped off by a Jonathan Stewart run. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So the ball switches back over to Tampa Bay, and as they get set in place on offense, Charles, talk about the running game and the O-line, where they stack up going in next year, because Doug Martin was only active for 8 games this last season. Rushing total dropped down to 400 yards, basically.
Yeah, they were fortunate they picked up Jaquizz Rodgers during the year.
It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Are going to retake the lead. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something, when you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. Well, sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. Hey, that's almost like one of your Turkey Bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Roberto Aguayo now for the point after. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. Well, the offense wasn't out there for a long time, but they were out there for a good time. One play, and they're able to hit pay dirt. For the touchdown, Aguayo now ready for the kickoff. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And last year that would have been a net. Gain of 5 on the return. This year he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. The Buccaneers defense making their way back out onto the field. Obviously a close game from the defensive standpoint. Maybe don't want to blow it too much out of proportion, but how important is this drive?
I think it's huge for them because they've got to find... whether it's doing it themselves, taking the ball away and scoring, or setting their offense up in a good position to give them a chance to fully be back in this game.
Yeah, sometimes that defense triggers the offense. We'll see. 2nd and 5. To throw on 2nd down is Newton. Man open left side is Brown. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8. On 2nd down, here's Newton. It's complete right side to Benjamin. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
Kelvin Benjamin bounced back from an ACL injury in 2015 to really good health in 2016 and had a 100-plus yard game early in the season, so it looked like he was all the way back. But Brandon, the rest of the year, never broke 100 yards again.
That is hard to believe. He had a stretch late in the season. He went 18 yards, 11 yards, 20 yards. That's just not what you expect from him and the Panthers.
Not at all. I don't think it's all his fault, but they're going to be looking for another breakout season from him next year.
And Olsen over the middle. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Now Newton on first down. And the tight end Olsen, right side. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. From the red zone now, Newton. He'll hit Whitaker on the flat. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first and goal.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in...
He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Their dangerous wide receiver from 3 yards out. And the Panthers are once again going to retake the lead. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route, ordinarily, is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And his kick is good. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30.
Illegal block in the back. Return team. On the right, first down.
Jameis now on first down. A dump off to Sims. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. He'll get a couple yards on that one. And it's a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play. But if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. 3 receivers to the left, 1 to the right. Second down, Winston. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. So 1:56 to play in this first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. So here we go, a third down after the second down pass completion. On third down, Winston. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now because they've made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
And he'll get this away into the humid Florida sky. Now it's Ginn.
Now, nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Panthers will get it here as they take possession. Cam Newton getting ready to go again on offense. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And now they're in the hurry up. On second down, here's Newton. And incomplete on the deep ball. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and it's third down.
Oh, man, for him to be that wide open and drop it. Sometimes you have just too much time on your hands, right? You end up thinking way too much, and your hands get shaky.
And yes, he's a tight end, but that's a catch he should have made. And you would have to think an obvious passing situation here on third and nine. They'll come out in the pistol. Throwing on third down, Newton. And he fires one, but incomplete. Tough ask here. They're going to go for it on fourth down and nine. They will go for it. Now Newton. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. And quickly, they get to the line. On first down, it's Newton. Flush to his right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. A big play there just before halftime. And even 50 yards. First down and goal to go from the 7. Now Stewart. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Newton now on second down. Flushed out right. And he will score. Touchdown, Panthers. Cam Newton, as the first half is winding down. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
And his kick is right through. So that winds up a 7-play drive all told. And Cam able to take it himself in for the score. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple of extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here with Sims. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Jameis to throw it. He gets it to Humphreys. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Final play of the half here, Winston.
into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. The Buccaneers are behind right now, but the home crowd should give them a boost. The Panthers have come in and look good as the road team, and will just keep trying to play hard and maintain the lead going forward. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Panthers take it at the one. Stewart's going to stay between the tackles. And finally on play 13, they score. The lead grows to four. First and 10, Winston's got the completion here, and this goes 76 yards for the score. They go ahead by a field goal. Midway through the second quarter, pass will be completed over the middle, and it will be caught for the score. They're now on top by four. Panthers now late in the second. Newton's on target here, and he'll eventually be brought down, but not before getting to the 7-yard line. Still a little time left on the clock. Newton's going to head outside to the right, and he caps off the 6-play drive with the score.
Okay, Larry, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Yeah, coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down. Well, you mind if we go off topic for a second?
No, let's
go. You know
go.
I like to do that
let's
randomly. Do AFC playoff contenders for this year that didn't make it last season. Who do you have that might get in?
Well, I think Cincinnati's got to be considered there. Maybe they'd have an offseason that's calm, and they go into this season and try and get back to the playoffs where they've been perennials. How about Denver?
Yeah.
Remember last year, they didn't have the quarterback to start. Trevor Siemian played pretty well overall, but maybe they can get solidified there and ride that strong defense right back into the playoffs. I'm going to give you a couple a little bit off the pace. Indianapolis cannot afford to squander Andrew Luck, one of the better young quarterbacks in the game. They've got to get back to the playoffs. And Buffalo, brand new head coach, brand new people running the ball club. Let's see if they can figure it out, because I think defensively they can be awfully strong. Third and 11, 5 in the secondary now.
Nickel look. Winston from the gun on third down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line.
Holding offense. The penalty is declined.
Here's Brian Anger now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. Gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Here's Ginn. Look at the spin.
Balance.
A terrific return. 30 yards all in all. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Panthers' offense now, they head back on the field for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. A play fake to Stewart. It's Newton. rolling to his right. And this is a catch by Ted Ginn. A good pickup there, a 22.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On first and 10, Newton. And Olsen over the middle. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. They give him 15 more, and it's another first down.
Smiles, everyone, smiles, because when Cam Newton and Greg Olsen hook up like they've been doing throughout this game, that's one big reason why they're winning.
What makes Greg Olsen so tough to cover?
I think he really is a wide receiver in a tight end's body. He runs his routes with such great precision and some physical toughness, and he really fights and competes for the ball.
And then, of course, it helps to have Cam Newton throwing it to you. And that'll be caught. Touchdown, Panthers. Olsen. Greg Olsen. A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Panthers add on to their lead. A diving catch for the score he laid out. That was special.
And you know the first thing they're going to check, right? Did he complete the process of the catch? All the way through, all the way to the ground. Ball doesn't hit the ground without control in his hands. All of that, yes. Check the box. Touchdown.
And the lead is up to 18 now. A drive there of just four plays. And Carolina scores to cap it off. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Here's the Panthers defense as they get set to go again. They were able to force that three and out. That led to a touchdown. And defenses obviously love three and outs. They want more of that.
They created a very short and not too sweet stint for the offense by getting them off the field that fast. But it set up their own offense, gave them a little spark, and they took it downfield and scored.
Now the question, can they do it again? Let's see. On the ground, the drive starts with Sims. And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And all the way down to the 35. A big play that time for Tampa Bay. And even 40 yards.
You got to feel a little bit for the defense there. They've done a terrific job all day long holding this guy in check. But that might have been the run to break things out for him, maybe turn things around. Now he's going to have some confidence, and maybe he'll get to his normal yardage.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Hey, boys, we got four down. Ready, move ready. Mike, check, 59.
They'll run it again with Sims. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Charles Johnson's stock in trade is coming off the edge and getting to the quarterback. He knows how to make some of those subtle moves inside to help in the run game, and he did it right there.
He's an athlete back in high school, played football, basketball, track, so he's a mobile guy.
Mobile guy, made a nice play against the run.
They'll run here with Sims. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Call it about a gain of three, and they'll be looking at a third and seven coming up.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball, because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
On third down, Winston. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Bucs are able to close the gap just a bit.
Well, if you've got him in your fantasy league, you like his production, his second touchdown of the game. But right now, his team is trailing. Fortunately, he's playing pretty well and trying to keep him in it.
Yeah, they might need a little more from him here.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they continue to call his number. Right now, he needs his defense to step up and give him a chance.
And he'll bang that one through. So that drive, four plays, and it ends with a touchdown for the Bucs. After the touchdown, Aguayo now ready for the kickoff. This will be fielded at the six. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
They'll start the drive with a run by Stewart. And he'll get this up to about the 40. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
They come up at an offset eye. Here's Newton. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They get nine out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Back now in Tampa. It's the Panthers out in front and in control of the football as well as we begin quarter number four. First down, Newton. It's caught right side, Dixon. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Carolina. Ed Dixon, 51 yards. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. They had the lead in the fourth, but still passing. Finding the big target for the touchdown. Now that lead grows even more.
Everybody gets to join in the fun. You know, it doesn't have to just be the wide receivers catching touchdown passes. The tight end doesn't just have to do just the dirty work inside. He gets a chance to get into the end zone as well.
Gano now to add the extra point. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And the end result, a Panthers touchdown. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Panthers defense gearing up as they take the field. And they gave up a touchdown last drive. You kind of need to hit the reset button after every touchdown given up, Charles.
I love that. And the way that you phrased it is perfect because from series to series, you can reset how the game is going to go. If you gave up a touchdown before, it doesn't mean you have to do it again. And if you made a great play before, you have to reset again anyway because they're going to attack. So I love the way you phrased it and put it out there. That's what they have to do in this series.
Not like when you're playing a video game. You can't hit the reset button here. Let's go.
No, you shouldn't anyway, that's for sure. I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So here we go, first and 10 now. Three receivers to the left, one to the right. First down, Winston. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Throwing again. Winston on second and 10. Over the middle to Evans. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
And this is caught by Jackson. And they get 14 yards there and a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
First and 10, Winston. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. On second down, Winston again. Schwartz has got it. That throw good for only a couple and brings up third down.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
The play fake to Sims, now Winston. Blitz coming and down he goes. Shaq Thompson coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest one is maybe you bring your running back in to try and keep you clean. But in that case, that didn't happen. Zero accountability, and a sack resulted.
Desperation time. Winston on fourth down. And it is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Panthers will get the football back. So a tough pill to swallow there. A would-be touchdown pass in and out of his hands on fourth.
Sometimes it just comes down to execution, doesn't it? Because we're always questioning, should they go for it, should they not? Is it the right play call? Is it not? In this situation, everything was right except for the finish. You have to catch the ball and convert.
We get a glance at the Buccaneer defense as they file into position. And maybe for them at this stage, it's sort of put up or shut up time. They need to stop trailing here.
Oh, I'm with you totally on that one. They've got to go out there now and put an end to what's been going on in this ball game where they've just given up points, gotten pushed around, so to speak, during this contest. They've got to find a way to end it right here, right now.
Can they end it? Let's find out. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. They'll get 19 yards there. And the Panthers are going to get a first down. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a 10th carry for Jonathan Stewart. And Stewart lost the football. It's loose.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Stewart is the lone setback. He's going to get the football. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. On first down, it's Newton. Escaping the pressure right. It's complete right side to Benjamin. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Well, there's one you don't see often, the illegal forward pass.
And the reason we don't see it very often is the quarterback has to be totally beyond the line of scrimmage for the flag to come out. If any part of the quarterback is behind the line of scrimmage when he throws the ball, then it's not an illegal forward pass.
Following the penalty, here's Stewart. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. So third and 20, defense in the nickel.
Surprised they didn't go with six DBs, the dime look.
So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. And the box with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. This is Whitaker. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on fourth and 10. On fourth down, Newton. And Ginn's got it. Touchdown, Carolina. Ted Ginn, 39 yards. And the Panthers add on to their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
And they open the lead up now to 25 points. So the drive there took six plays, and Carolina scores to cap it off. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And last year that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. So out come the Bucs now. They're down big here late. I don't know. Just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once, we were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better
as they continue to
move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Winston now. Charles Sims, the intended target, and it's third and short.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out or check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Three yards left to grab here on third down. Third and short yardage, Winston. A dump off to Sims. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Winston now to throw on first down. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. On second down, Winston again. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. Jameis now on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. Now Jameis on second down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. The tight end Cameron Brate was the target, and it's third down. Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Third and long for Winston. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Trey Boston. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent. And now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Carolina getting set to take the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long from Tampa.
Just a bunch of poor boys, daddy's girls, children of the cornfield, trying to turn a shift job into a dollar bill. We wear the muddy boots, stay true to how we're raised. Ain't nothing about us fake. You know we're straight out of that dirty south, dirty roads. Nobody got no money, got them signed up pickup trucks, whistling at them from the country.